is our second year of sonography. I'm really excited and also anxious as well. So we're going to have two classes, OBGYN and also abdomen. In addition to that, we also have to go to 4 days of clinical. With proper management, time management, and planning, I think we both will be successful in the program. Don't you think so?
I think so too.
I'm here just because my home is under remodeling, kind of noisy. Here, MLC is the only place I can focus on study. And it's usually the place we students in a program take a midterm and final examination. Let's go inside and take a look at it.
Hi, I'm Sarah Arnett, and I'm an instructional associate here in the Medical Learning Center. We provide computer support for all health sciences programs, and we have textbooks on reserve, supplemental video support for your classwork, and we also provide computer support and printing support and any other needs that students might have outside of the classroom.
So today's Thursday, we don't have class today, but I'm here to do the simulator, which is one of the assignments that we have to do as a class requirement. So this is it. So right now I'm doing the TV core with the nuchal translucency. And so as you can see that I finished some of the practice. So right now I'm gonna do the examination of the gestational sac.
Today. It's about 10 minutes from my house, so it's much more convenient than the over an hour commute I had to DC. It's a strictly OB clinical site, so the studies are much more detailed than the other OB site I was at, and I look forward to really improving these OB scans.
In order to avoid traffic, I chose to come in at 7 o'clock in the morning. Right now it's 6:46 a.m. Very dark outside. It looks like I'm working at a night shift. Here comes the shuttle, which will take me to Holy Cross Hospital. Right now I'm at the church. Almost 8 o'clock, I'm here. This is usually the place I transfer patients from the holding area to the examination room for the ultrasound study. Okay, it's my world now. Usually when there's no patient, man sitting in this room, spending the time studying, doing homework, reading the school note.
Every time after I do a competency on the patients,
I have to go to a file room to get CD burnout because this machine doesn't have a USB port.
Soiled transvaginal probe is stored in a red container. Blue container is for clean transvaginal probe.
October 24. Today at the clinical site, I saw a very interesting case. I was scanning a patient's pelvis for 2 or 3 minutes, and then I asked the CI to come in, help me out. What we saw was a snake-like tubular structure, hypoechogenic, which makes the uterus look small. But what was funny was when I measured the uterus, it was actually 11 centimeters in length. What was more interesting was that 2 hours before the ultrasound examination, CT scan was saying that this patient had a normal female pelvis.
So I just finished my OB clinical at Rockville, and right now I'm actually at Montgomery College in Rockville to do some studying before heading home. Usually I don't go home until maybe around 7. That's when traffic usually dies down.
Semester, so we have midterm coming up. Our OB midterm is coming up, so we just have a little study sessions to study and, you know, get ready for the midterm.
So I just finished my OB clinical at Rockville, and right now I'm actually at Montgomery College in Rockville to do some studying before heading home. Usually I don't go home until maybe around 7. That's when traffic usually dies down.
Downtown Silver Spring, October 6th, in the morning. Good morning, ma'am. Ready to go. You have 410 guests today. Beat the time, beat the traffic.
Xiao xiao xing xing liang jing jing, yi shan yi shan fang guang ming.
So we just finished taking our midterm, so I finally get some time to relax a little bit, even got my hair cut.